What peptides should I take from muscle growth? Now this is interesting because all the fitness influencers, biohackers, a lot of people have been talking about muscle these days. And actually I just read a book called Stronger. And that book is phenomenal because it goes through the history of muscle and what early doctors thought about muscle from, you know, you look at Galen, you go to Hippocrates, and there is this tension between the athletes building a lot of muscle versus some of the doctors of the time that thought that they were putting on too much flesh and it was a threat to some of the religious ideology at the time. So what we're going to dive into today in this video is all of the peptides that can help you maximize muscle growth without compromising your future health. And so I'm excited to share this with you. So I'm Regan Archibald. I'm someone who has been obsessed with helping people get as healthy as possible in the shortest amount of time possible. I've worked with some of the greatest entrepreneurs on the planet and helped them achieve the highest level of health so that they can get on stage, they can perform their best, they can also work with their teams and make a big impact in their world. The thing that I found that differentiates the very successful entrepreneurs who we work with from the ones who are trying to achieve success is the difference in the mindset around health. The people who focus on their health and they make that their number one priority, everything falls into place. Their spirituality is, they're more connected to God, they're more connected to their family. They also feel a deeper sense of purpose and meaning because they have their health and their vitality. And there's three systems that we look at that comprise of helping your body optimize its function, and that's the muscle, which we're talking about right now, it's the brain, and it's the heart. So why is muscle important? Well, muscle informs every other organ system in your body as to how healthy you are or are not. Muscles release these peptides called myokines. And these myokines are interesting because they inform your brain. They say, hey, Regan needs more neural mass and because his grip strength increased and his lats are growing. And so your brain actually develops new neural pathways to support that extra muscle. On the flip side, if Regan's muscle is decreasing, then the brain becomes less and less active. It's called the neuromuscular adaptation. So there's the brain, the neuro, and the muscles are continually in this dynamic tension where the brain is sensing what the muscles can do and functions they can perform, and also the muscles are getting signals from the brain so that they can move. And if you don't believe me that the brain governs the muscles and kind of the movement, then just try to like block a nerve, do a nerve block and try to move your hand. It just doesn't work because the nerve is no longer activated. So how do you build muscle with peptides? Well, if you think about peptides, peptides are protein structures that turn on genes in your body. And in your body, it's a feedback system. So just like any system in your business, system in your house, there's always these feedback loops. There's a negative feedback loop and a positive feedback loop. So if you have just an endless expression of a peptide called follistatin, then what you're going to find is your muscle mass just will continually build. And there's no braking system. Myostatin is the peptide that puts on the brakes. And so one of the best peptides that we found is a peptide called ACE031. And what this peptide is a myostatin inhibitor. So it just gently takes off the brakes so that the accelerant can move a little faster. In the studies, they used it originally for these teenage boys who had Duchenne's muscular dystrophy. They were able to improve their gait. They were able to improve their muscle mass and their contractility. Another study, they took postmenopausal women who had sarcopenia, and they noticed that they were developing a lot of fat tissue around their thighs specifically. And after using a cycle of ACE031, they found that these weekly injections for 30 days, they are able to lose 9% of the adipose tissue on their thighs while gaining 5% of lean muscle mass. That's phenomenal. Now, ACE31, it's a peptide that leaves a welt. So you'll probably notice that. So you want to inject it a little deeper. Most of these peptides is a subcutaneous injection. It's very simple. But for some reason, ACE031, it can leave a little bit of a welt. But one of the things I notice when I do cycles of this, I'll do 60-day cycles, and I'll do that twice a year. But I notice I can pull out 2 or 3 more reps. I can do pull-ups easier. I can also find that I have a little better proprioception. So ACE031 is one of the great peptides for working on that follistatin pathway when it comes to muscle building. Now, if we shift gears a little bit and we say, okay, what about growth hormone? Can growth hormone help build muscle? Well, growth hormone helps us recover, and it does indirectly help build muscle. And so one of the things that I found is a peptide called tesamorelin. And tesamorelin is 43 amino acid chains. It is prescribed as Egrifta. It was FDA approved for patients who had lipodystrophy, so they had this belly that had a lot of visceral fat. And it led to a lot of these patients who were on treatments for HIV. The tesamorelin actually led to a decline and a decrease in their visceral fat. They also gained muscle. So tesamorelin is phenomenal. We call it the fat burner or the six-pack peptide, because what it does is it helps you build muscle while you're burning fat. And that's the real key, because it's working on growth hormone pathway, but activating another system called mTOR. Now, mTOR, many of us in the longevity space, we say we don't want to overexpress mTOR. So how can we mediate the risks of being on something like a growth hormone peptide? And that's where you look at the other part, the brakes. Remember, everything's got a gas and a brake. And so then you go, okay, well, what could activate AMPK, which is kind of the braking system for mTOR? And that's where we'd use MOD-SC. And MOD-SC is phenomenal because it actually is from the skeletal muscles. That's where you're going to find the most abundant supply of this peptide called MOD-SC. And when MOD-SC is expressed, you're going to get this activation of AMPK. And you get about 400 to 500% greater expression of MOD-SC just when you exercise. So you want to be exercising all the time, and then you want to be using these growth hormones, working on mTOR, work on AMPK. And then think follistatin, think myostatin. And then that's where you can bring in the ACE031 or SS31. The SS31 is a mitochondrial peptide that repairs any mitochondrial damage and helps eliminate any kind of oxidative stress or reactive oxygen species that can accumulate in your body when you're in this building phase. Now, the next thing that you want to consider when it comes to muscle growth is the BPC-157 and thymosin beta-4. These are going to work on a totally different pathway because they're working on the circulatory system. So if you think of our muscles are fed by the heart. And that's why I call this the ageless axis, your brain, your heart, your muscles. And when you've got good vascularity or good blood supply to muscles, your muscles can improve, they can recover. When you hit that lactic acid threshold, we've all felt it, where you get that soreness, and then we get the delayed onset muscle soreness, but you get soreness where your output just starts to dwindle. But one of the things that these peptides, BPC-157 and thymosin beta-4 do, is they're angiogenic. So they create new blood supply. They activate nitric oxide, and nitric oxide is one of the most powerful signaling gases in your body. It is a vasodilator. Nitric oxide is released when you're in a loving state and you have more oxytocin. But the other thing is BPC and thymosin beta-4, they mobilize stem cells into the areas of your body that have been damaged. So they help mediate any kind of pain. So if you're looking to build muscle, you want to think of these three things. You want to think, okay, how can I activate the follistatin? How can I activate mTOR? And how can I activate the reparative properties in my body so that I can get the gains? Because as you know, you don't build muscle when you're in the gym. Actually, that's when you're tearing your muscle down. The recovery is what really builds things. And that's when you get great sleep. If you don't sleep great, this is where you want to add in the DSIP, or deep sleep inducing peptide, and epitalin. And these peptides help regulate that circadian rhythm so that your body's optimized, so you can build muscle, so that you can feel your best, look your best, perform your best, no matter what age you are, and you can do those athletic things that you've always loved. Who cares if your friends are sitting on the couch? Go do what you love, because you've taken the time to focus on your health. And that is one of the most valuable things you can do, no matter what level of success you are in life. There's always room for improvements in your health. Okay, the fourth thing you want to consider when it comes to muscle building is your testosterone levels. Now, testosterone is a powerful, powerful hormone when it comes to muscle building because it allows you to sustain the muscle that you've built. I don't know if you've ever noticed, but you know, if your testosterone is not optimized, you'll build muscle, but then you'll lose it. And testosterone is actually very cardioprotective. So what that means is it protects your heart. And there's more receptors in your heart for testosterone than your entire body combined. And so it becomes really important for you to have really healthy expression of testosterone. The other thing that is activated with testosterone is your prefrontal cortex. Now, it's a well-known fact that men are more risk-taking than women generally, and a lot of people say it's because of the testosterone. And whether that's true or not, I don't know, but I do know that men do have more receptors in their brain for testosterone, generally speaking. But when you have testosterone in your body, it makes effort feel good. It's where you can do something that's really hard and challenging, and you just step up like a man. You have the masculine trait where you want to take things on that you've never taken on before. On the flip side, I run a lot of labs, and when we look at men's testosterone levels, we just notice that they feel pretty despondent. They don't have the juice. They accomplish something big and they're like, meh. You know, it just wasn't that exciting after all. I like Naval Ravikant. He says, you know, the definition of success is getting what you want. The definition of happiness is wanting what you've got. So it's like with testosterone, even if you get what you want, you don't have the happiness. There's not that reward system because it's a dopamine modulator. Dopamine is that neurotransmitter that just helps us feel like we've done something really meaningful. And it's aligned with our sole purpose. But what I found is with testosterone levels being low, no matter what level of success you're at, you just don't quite feel that pulse. You know, one of my clients, it was interesting because his testosterone is in the 500s, so it's just suboptimal. We want your total testosterone to be in 700 to 900 range. And what he said, he's like, well, I don't really want to get on testosterone because I have to take it nonstop. Once I get on it, my body will stop producing it. And I said, well, that's right, but there's microdosing we can do with testosterone, and that's typically how we introduce our patients to it. But there's actually some natural peptides that you can utilize to maximize your testosterone. Now, there's treatments like enclomiphene that work on the luteinizing and follicular stimulating hormone pathways. That's great. But you can also use a peptide called gonadirellin. And gonadirellin works on the gonadotropin releasing hormone pathway. And that pathway stimulates your testes to produce more testosterone. And subsequently, it's actually really good for sperm count. But it's stress that turns off that pathway. So if you have high levels of stress, there's a good chance you're going to have low levels of testosterone. Even if you eat clean, you exercise, you have great sleep hygiene, you have good libido, those are all fine. You can still have low testosterone because of the enormous amount of stress and pressure you put on yourself. So gonadirellin is a peptide that is very powerful, not just for fertility. If you're looking to have babies, you want to increase your sperm count, that is going to be a phenomenal treatment, but it's really good to circumvent the stress and help your testosterone levels increase. Kisspectin is the other pathway, and it does stimulate directly through the luteinizing and follicular stimulating hormone pathways, and people notice an improvement in libido. Kisspectin out of Stanford University, they also found that it helped reverse fatty liver disease in patients who took it for up to 6 months. So if you're thinking of optimizing testosterone, but you want to do it in a way that's not necessarily through testosterone itself, that's where peptides are really important because remember, to build muscle, you want to have that follistatin activation, and that's where you build really healthy muscle. So just take off the brakes a little bit and cycle these, and then you want to think about, okay, how can I work on mTOR with growth hormone? And then use MOD-SC to activate the AMPK so you downregulate any kind of risk. And then recovery, BPC-157, thymus and beta-4. And then how do I optimize my hormones so that I can keep the muscle that I made? And that's where testosterone comes in. And if you need testosterone, we'll run your labs, and that's something we can do as a team here at East West. But we'll also use peptides so that your body makes its own testosterone because that's the best supply. So there's one thing that you want to think of when it comes to muscle, and that becomes your protein synthesis. And I've got lots of videos on that, but you want to make sure that you're lifting weights, you've got the what's called the hypertrophy strength building, but you also want to be working on proprioception and those fast twitch muscle fibers because That's what goes first. And so at East West, what we'll do is we'll run your comprehensive blood labs and we'll determine exactly what peptides are going to be best to help you build muscle and to help you hold on to the muscle. But then on the flip side, we'll make sure you've got the right fitness protocol and the right nutritional protocol so that you can maximize the time that's spent in the gym and the time that that's spent recovering so that you can have the health of your dreams. And you'll find that in your next business venture, next trip that you go on, the next date you go on with your spouse, you're going to feel far more energized. You'll have more confidence because you've been able to change your body composition. So if you love this video, you want to go deeper and you want to look at how you can transform your entire life and your entire health, go to agelessfuture.com. One of the things that we offer is a retreat, these longevity retreats where we run all the diagnostics for your body, your blood work. We do carotid artery scans, VO2 max testing. We'll run you through our fitness 50 benchmarks and ask my team if you can come to the retreat as a friend of Regan. So we're friends now because you watched the video. So go to agelessfuture.com. Click on the link, fill out the form, and then ask my team about a retreat, and I'll see you there. Can't wait to spend some time with you.